Welcome to Weld.com. I'm gonna run a new product here. I'm gonna try some Blue Demon 308L FCO gasless flux core wire. When I was mocking this up, I read the technical specs, and I'm running off of ESOB Rebel 235, and I went through a bunch of different settings. And what I noticed was, this is, to me, it's a little odd. I guess I'm stuck on the carbon steel wires and the DCEN and how you can get that good tight sizzle. But this one's a little bit different. I'm running DCEP. I'm gonna do a volt range of 28, and I'm doing 465 on my wire feed speed, 035, okay? So what I'm noticing while I'm doing this is, and it's kind of weird, it's like there's always a big ball on the end of the wire. Okay, and I'm thinking, wow, that's strange. I want to get rid of it. I'm not able to get rid of it. I went through a bunch of different settings. It's always there. I turned this thing way down on the low end, and you can do some, I want to say 23.5, 24 volts, and lower that wire feed speed where you get a lower amperage. You can make a smaller weld. I want to do a 10 gauge fillet weld, and then I want to do a 1/4 inch fillet weld. And I'm noticing that, to me, I get more of an acceptable appearance by going ahead and running it hot and just going faster, you know, even on the thinner material. So I want to experiment a little bit. I already see some benefits to this. You know, stainless, you know, we're running different gases with stainless. You can weld it with C25. You'll get a little bit of a gray weld. I think we did a video on that when we did it in comparison with a tri-blend of gas with the helium. But you know, if you can do this without gas, if I was doing some stuff around the house and I had a quick repair, or if I had a small fab job and I had a roll of wire and I didn't want to go through the expense of gas, I'm definitely grabbing this stuff right here. So let me get some sleeves on. I'll be right back. This wire calls for a 3/4 to 1 inch stick out. I'm gonna let this one cool. I want to go over here to this thicker material, this 1/4 inch. I did do a test weld on it. I'm gonna experiment and do something here. I'm gonna go into this corner with a push, pretty good push angle, and then I'm gonna leave it set for the camera guy over here, and I'm gonna do a pretty good pull. When I get that to about an inch or so, then I'm just gonna rotate the gun and see if I can't tie into those, just to see how it's gonna react. I noticed a couple of things here. I really expected it. The ball on the end of the wire is always there. What I really expected to happen is this extreme push angle that I used. I really thought I'd get a lot of BBs and buckshot that came out on the material. It didn't. And then I turned around and I dragged this in here at a pretty good angle. Same thing. It looked like it was spattering a lot. but it really is not on the material. So I need to get with the manufacturer and have a little conversation. I need to learn how to run their product better. You know, it's the first time for me to run it, but I think this is kind of cool, really. It's one of those things that just kind of looks weird. Got to get used to it. We did a video a while back and we compared two flux core wires, a Lincoln and a Harbor Freight, and you know, they have some unique characteristics, and certainly this one does too. But again, you know, let's think the advantages. Okay, we're not using any gas. You know, this is pretty quick. I'm gonna go cool this off. I'm curious to know what these look like. I think I may have missed that fillet weld over on one part of it. You know, again, it's a wire feed process, but it has flux around it. So, you know, if in order for me to really concentrate on the weld pool itself, you know, I'd equate this to stick because it's got the slag all around it. So again, I'm gonna go cool this off. I'll do some chipping and buffing. I probably want to get some B-roll of some color if it's there before I do any wire wheel work, so I'll be right back. I cooled this one off. I didn't do anything to this one here. Cooled off on its own. By the way, I was using this block back here not as a heat sink or anything, just to steady the material in case I bumped the wire and it didn't get going. Anyway, on this particular weld, it has a decent profile. I probably over-weld it, and I noticed that I kind of missed a little bit to the downside. I guess I was mesmerized by that ball thing going off there on the end of the wire. That's still, to me, I haven't made continuous welds with that going on. So, and again, first time for me to run this, and I want to get more technical specs and some advice on everything, but I see some real definite advantages to doing this for quick work on structural. Here's what I do notice, and here's what I like. Even though this thing sounds like it's spattering and it's out of control and all that, and again, I said I went through a lot of different settings back here. It still had that strange effect where that ball was on the end of the wire, and I think the camera guy got it pretty well. But, you know, again, I missed this a little bit to the downside. It's still in there. I've got some slag showing where I didn't wire buff it hard. I get over here on this weld. I have a couple of these hard spatters. I know that happened when I tacked it. I don't have any of them in the weld. I don't have any of these big old spatter things sitting on top of the plate that are hard to chip off. The ones that were on there were fairly small, and I knocked them off with the chipping hammer with very little effort. Okay, my big ones that I can't get off of here are when I tack the material on here. Now, can you take them off? Yeah, I could take those off with a die grinder or a small thin bladed grinder and just kind of wash them back a little bit. The profile of this weld on the quarter inch material is actually pretty sweet. So, you know, I think it's a great product. I just need to learn to run it better, correctly, spend some time with it, but I see some definite advantages. Again, Blue Demon 308L FCO, gasless flux core wire, and this rascal runs on DCEP. DCEP, and I ran this on the flux core program on the Rebel 235. Okay, so you know, I learned a little bit here. I'm hoping you did too. Please subscribe to the videos. Thanks for watching Weld.com. Thank you.